Hey friends, hope you're well. I've been using these smart glasses for a full month non-stop, and these are the Nreal Air augmented reality glasses, and it's a really exciting glimpse into the future. They're essentially AR smart glasses that look and wear like normal sunglasses. After seeing movies like Minority Report and Iron Man years ago, I've hoped that augmented reality will become, well, a reality, something that's actually accessible and useful for daily use. And after a month of use with these glasses, it's opened up a world where I can access a huge 201-inch triple monitor setup anywhere to work off my MacBook, watch movies, play games, no matter where I am. And in this video, I'll show you how they work, how I use them, and what this all looks like for the future of smart glasses, especially with Apple's rumored AR/VR headset on the horizon. A big thanks to Nreal for sending these out, sponsoring today's video, and as always, all opinions are still my own, so let's put these on and try them out. The first thing I noticed is these smart glasses are lightweight, exactly 80 grams, which is under 3 ounces, and just a little heavier than your average sunglasses, so they've been pretty comfortable to wear for long periods of time. When I first connected the glasses to my Oppo X5 with the provided USB-C cable, I was amazed at the incredibly huge 201-inch virtual display it projected. It's so large, I had to literally turn my head side to side to see the entire full-size display. It also works with an iPhone as long as you have an adapter, but I actually found myself using the glasses a lot with my MacBook. Nreal's recently updated Nebula feature projects my MacBook screen into this huge virtual multi-screen setup through the glasses, and I'll show you more of this later in this video. I'm going to do the best I can to demonstrate the AR glasses as realistically as possible, but as I found out while filming this video, it's actually really tricky filming what AR looks like, so please bear with me while I do my best to give you a taste of what it looks like. So here's how the glasses actually project an augmented reality image. There are two dual 1080p displays behind the glasses working in unison. They're actually Sony micro OLED displays that reach up to 400 nits brightness. And so when I put these on, the two separate displays are combined together into one by our smart brains, or more accurately, it tricks our brains, which gives the illusion of projected 3D depth. Pop on the included light shield to not only look more like a cyberpunk badass, it also turns these AR glasses into a more blackout VR-like experience, which I've found perfect for when you don't want your surroundings distracting you, like on a commute or on the plane. Navigating the menu and working from the glasses is as simple as using the connected phone as a pointer and controller, or using your connected mouse and keyboard via your laptop. Both have worked pretty well for me. And I must say, these AR glasses are much better than most AR/VR headsets I've used in the past, like the older Oculus Quest 1 and HTC Vive, simply thanks to its high brightness, quality display, and portable form factor. The Nreal Air glasses support a 46-degree field of view, and there's no grainy effect you typically find in older VR/AR headsets. Animations and on-screen smoothness is even better in person than I can actually display on video here, and it's extremely bright for viewing even in sunlight. It's quite a pleasant viewing experience that I didn't expect based on my previous experiences with AR. There are also two open speakers near the temples with volume rockers, and the sound quality is decent, but nothing to write home about, so I find that headphones are a must for a more immersive experience when it comes to these. There are two head tracking modes, fixed so the screen stays in a single spot in your environment, or tracked so the AR screens are centered no matter where you turn. I preferred mine tracked because it feels more immersive that way, but fixed is the better option if you're planning to sit down and work with multiple screens. And speaking of using multiple screens for work, I want to show you some of the mind-blowing immersive features and apps I've been using over the last month. I've been having an absolute blast with these. One of the exciting recently updated features is the ability to connect the glasses to a M1 or M2 Mac through the Nebula app. Don't worry, Windows users, apparently a Windows app is being launched in the next few months. So I connected it to my MacBook Pro M2 and the result is seriously incredible, similar to what we've seen in Meta Quest Pro's pass-through mode. It works in single screen, dual screen or triple screen modes, and in each mode there's 3 degrees of freedom to give this immersive visual representation of multiple monitors levitating in front of you. At times I really felt like Tony Stark. It's something that needs to be tried in person for an extended time to appreciate just how futuristic of a gadget this is. Having 3 legitimate monitors on the go in such a portable form factor is a true game changer, and I think productivity enthusiasts are really going to appreciate this. In the previous month, I wrote emails, used Slack, used Google Docs, created a report, and even tried video editing on the virtual triple screen monitor at home, cafes, and even on the plane for a little bit. And even though it did have its pitfalls, which I'll mention in a moment, it did for the most part feel like I had 3 screens in front of me that I worked off no problem at all. Battery life kept up well, I got about 5 hours of work in before a charge, screen mirroring worked smoothly, my Bluetooth keyboard and mouse paired fine, and most importantly, I didn't feel nauseous at all considering I took the usual breaks away from my desk. So overall, it's way better than I expected, but it's not without its flaws. Sometimes the depth of field tracking was jittery, so it can be distracting. If you accidentally loosen the cable as well, everything sort of shuts down, taking away all the AR screens and apps with it, which is quite inconvenient. And overall, the AR experience does take a little time to get used to. The Nreal Airs are also an amazing gaming companion. Connecting these to my Nintendo Switch is a whole other world of immersive. Playing Mario Kart 8 on these glasses felt as if I had a cockpit view of the kart itself, since it was so close to my face, and I've easily dropped a few hours karting around through these glasses and I didn't even realize a few hours had passed. Breath of the Wild was breathtakingly stunning on an AR screen, feeling like I was actually flying around the fields of Hyrule, and I was able to appreciate the beauty of the world more than ever. A heads up when it comes to gaming, the 201-inch AR mode is only available for high-end Android phones and Xbox Cloud Gaming. For devices like the Steam Deck, Switch, and PS5, we're limited to the 130-inch gaming screen, which is already large enough to fill my field of vision though. I can see a lot of people getting these glasses as a gaming companion and using it for nothing else but gaming and watching content. The aircasting mode, which mimics your phone's screen, is great for watching Netflix or YouTube in a cinema-like experience, but it does drain the battery quickly. So wearing it over a month now, I've gotten pretty used to these, and it helps that these actually look closer to normal sunglasses more than ever. Definitely more than the original Google Glass. Anyone remember those? The best way that I can describe the design is that they look like a slightly enlarged version of sleek Wayfarer sunglasses, a silhouette that I personally really like, and they're by far the best looking wearable glasses that I've come across. They even support prescription lenses, and there's a range of nose pads to make sure that they don't slip off your face, so design wise, these are a huge step in the right direction for smart glasses and wearable tech. They're undeniably portable and something you can slip into your pocket or bag with the included case. I've even taken these out to a cafe, sipped on a drink, and watched Netflix while still being able to see the entire cafe. The best part of it all is that no one knew I was watching Netflix on a freaking 201-inch screen while chilling at the cafe. They did probably think though, why was this weirdo wearing sunglasses indoors? But it was totally worth it. So I think I'm now realizing just how useful smart glasses and augmented reality can be for work and play, especially when the wearable is this portable and discreet. The Nreal Air glasses are one of the most impressive smart glasses on the market right now. And to be able to have these virtual portable screens to work from, especially on the long haul flights that I've been on recently, it's been seriously enjoyable, and the best part is not a single person pulled me up to ask what sort of weird device I was wearing on my face. It's not without its shortcomings, but some refinements to its tracking software and the removal of the USB-C cable, and we'd have arguably one of the best tech wearables full stop. As it stands right now, it's still an incredible device, allowing a quick smartphone tether to take any content from your phone, Mac, or gaming console into a bigger virtual screen. And for that ability alone, for many that'd be worth the $379 price tag. And regardless, it's a really exciting glimpse into the future of smart glasses. I'm also looking for gaming and movie recommendations to watch on these glasses, so let me know down in the comments what I should watch. And if you made it to the very end of this video, also drop the code word comment sci-fi and I'll give it a like. I'll leave a video right here to my 200-inch projector setup in my studio if you want to see an at-home big screen setup, which is also amazing for games and movies when I'm at home. And as always, thanks for watching and I'll see you in the next video.